Few people know how detrimental wildfire smoke has been for vineyard owners across Washington, Oregon, and California. In 2020, grapes from the region were found to be unfit to be made into wine due to an ashy flavor known as smoke taint, costing the wine industry an estimated $3 billion.
All of a sudden, a very big problem was happening for the entire industry across the state. I don't know any place that didn't have at least some sort of a problem with smoke exposure in 2020.
It's definitely something that the industry here is very familiar with, but it certainly has seemed to increase in severity and frequency.
A group of Oregon State researchers may have found the answer to smoke taint in a form of edible coatings. A big step for the U.S. wine industry. Alec Levin researches wine grape production in the university's Southern Oregon Research and Extension Center in Central Point.
We're doing controlled smoking experiments where we've put cages on grapevines and then measure yield and quality to see what are the numbers in the air or numbers in the fruit that cause problems.
Elizabeth Tomasino researches flavor chemistry of wine grapes.
Of course, the easiest way to stop this off flavor from happening is we don't have fires. Since that is out of my control, the next best thing to do is stop the compounds from entering the grapes should a wildfire and smoke occur in the vineyard.
Her interests lie in wine sensory analysis. Her team recently narrowed down key compounds linking smoke exposure to wine's ashy flavor, allowing wine growers to test for smoke exposure before the winemaking process.
That's why it becomes so important that we find feasible, economical, applicable technology to resolve these problems. It has been used in the field and for post-harvest fruits and vegetables.
Yan Yun Zhao, a distinguished professor in food science and technology, has been studying food coatings for more than 20 years. Zhao believes the same technology can be adapted to eliminate smoke exposure altogether for wine grapes.
Mostly we focus on water resistant, good barrier to water, to oxygen.
These coatings are being tested in a custom-built smoke diffusion box. This is a sealed chamber about the size of a 32-ounce mason jar. Researchers found the coatings block specific smoke compounds known as volatile phenols, linked to smoke exposure. Think of all this like this. As a vineyard owner, you are notified of a fire spreading 50 miles north of your vineyard. You used to only have two options. Take the chance and hope the wind will carry the smoke far away from your vineyard, missing it completely. Or hope the grape's smoke taint isn't noticeable during the winemaking process. But now you may have another option.
Do you see something in the future where there is a coating available that can be applied to the grapes that do not affect grape growth in any other way, that can stop these smoke compounds from entering the grapes in the first place, so you won't have to worry about smoke impacts or smoke taint in your finished product?
You may be concerned by the concept of a clear coating being sprayed on grapes grown for winemaking. Researchers say these coatings are being made from edible compounds such as cellulose, one of the most abundant organic compounds on Earth. Cellulose is found in many leafy fruits and vegetables such as celery and pears.
It's a very good stability and elasticity, which not preventing the growth of wine grapes.
These researchers aim to create coatings that are both durable and non-toxic, eliminating the need for washing before fermentation. This saves water, something in short supply in many wine-growing regions.
We did find in the second iteration that 5 of the 8 compounds were significantly decreased, but of course we want to try and decrease all of the compounds.
There's still a lot of testing to be done, which will require an application just before a fire event, something that has become all too common during the recent years.
When you think like what can a grower do in the event of a wildfire exposure, it's not a lot. So you have to just do preventative measures. Still in the very much development phase, but we've gotten some promising results.
these Oregon State researchers expect to have the spray coatings available and ready to be applied very soon, giving a little hope to the wine grape industry.